Meanwhile, Pakistan, which uses terrorism as its state policy and spends endlessly on terror designs, is now targeting innocent Kashmiri youth to finance its nefarious activities. These youth are tricked by Pak-backed terrorist and pro-Pakistan organization under the guise of providing higher education in Pakistan, subsequently turning them into highly trained terrorists. Recently, Indian security forces busted the terror funding module of Pakistan and arrested four Hurriyat members for procuring medical seats in Pakistan for Kashmiri students in lieu of money which was used for fueling terrorism in Jammu and Kashmir.
Unveiling Pakistan's vicious agendas in Kashmir, Indian security forces arrested four persons associated with the Hurriyat conference, including Zafar Akbar Bhatt, a former Hizbul Mujahideen commander, for selling MBBS and other professional courses seats in Pakistan to Kashmiri students and using the money to support and fund terrorism. However, two of the accused are still absconding and are living in Pakistan right now. A conservative estimate indicated that the money involved could be around 4 crore per annum on the basis of the fact that allocation of seats for distribution by individual Hurriyat leaders was around 40 seats for MBBS program every year. Moreover, these seats were consciously given to the relatives or close ones of killed terrorists. It was revealed in the report that the Pakistani ISI kicked off this program in order to incentivize terrorism by compensating the families of killed terrorists. The money collected from the parents of the aspiring or potential students was used by Pakistan to support and fund terrorism and militancy in Kashmir Valley.
इस तफ्तीश में ये भी पाया गया है कि कोई 80 के करीब ऐसे केसेस MBBS के जो अभी तक तफ्तीश ने निकाले हैं जो हुर्रियत के चैनल से जो हैं वो पाकिस्तान गए. ये भी मालूम हुआ है कि 10 से 12 लाख रुपए की रकम एक सीट के लिए देनी पड़ती थी और बहुत बड़ी रकम इस जरिए से अगर 40 के करीब केसेस पर ईयर भी देखें तो जमा होती थी जो लगभग 4 करोड़ के लगभग एक साल की कलेक्शन बनती है.
Moreover, Pakistan has been drawing Kashmiri students to join the terror ranks under the guise of student visa. This month, three terrorists belonging to Lashkar-e-Taiba were gunned down in Kashmir's Bandipora district. One of them was identified as Shakir Altaf Bhatt of Bandipora. His killing and subsequent finding that he has left the country on a valid passport for studies in Pakistan in 2018 and returned as a terrorist set alarm bells ringing in the security establishment in Jammu and Kashmir. Shakir Altaf is not an isolated case. As per Jammu and Kashmir police, there has been an increase in the number of youth who had travelled to Pakistan for studies and had infiltrated back into the country as trained terrorists. This is in addition to over 100 Kashmiri youths who travel to Pakistan on valid visas for short durations and have either not come back or disappeared after their return in the last 3 years.
There are cases, earlier I had shared that there are 57 cases of people who had gone across, youth who had gone across, majority of them students, went on student visa. What studies? That is not sure, but the fact they went on student visa and when they went there, they went to the training camps, they were taken to the training camps and then when they came back as terrorists. But that number 57 is not a fixed number. That is the number that came to our notice. This number could be even more. We are working out more such cases where people went on student visa and their particulars are either not known or it's not known whether they have come back. That process of verification is on.
Pakistan has been scrambling in recent months to avoid being added to a list of countries deemed non-compliant with anti-money laundering and terrorist financing regulations by the Global Watchdog, a measure that could further hurt its economy. However, be it deadly terror attacks, illegal drugs or manpower supply, or radicalization of Kashmiri youth, Pakistan has not deferred itself from indulging into anti-Indian activities. Islamabad's decades-long obsession with Kashmir has led to deprivation of food and development in the country. But despite its internal instability, failing economy and international isolation, the country does not compromise when it comes to funding terrorists.